Good afternoon, everybody. Myself, Mahendra Pratap Singh, Faculty Computer Engineering Department, and my colleague.
Myself, Dinesh Naik. I belong to the youngest department in our NITK. First of all, I would like to tell you this. So far, this computer programming is concerned. This course assignment has been given to the computer department. So my colleague Mahendra Singh Pratap going to speak on different issues.
First of all, because this year is very important year for us, we completed 50 years of existence in the technical education. And so this year we are going to celebrate as a golden jubilee year. So on behalf of our director NITK, I'm inviting you all, and especially sir, if you have some time and come and visit us between this or otherwise in the month of December when we have a program, so that we have some special kind of events on that time. And now here, especially I am going to discuss about the computer programming course that we have here at our NITK. And as he said, this computer programming course is fully handled by the Department of Computer Engineering. So this is just little bit about the Department of Computer Engineering at NITK. It somewhat started in 1986, and now the current situation, we have around 250 UG students along with 110 postgraduate student. We have two M.Tech streams, and then around 20 PhD students. But managing of this much big force, we have around 11 faculties, and out of 11, 12 are on leave. So you can say we are only 9, and it's very difficult for us to manage all those things. So with the TAs, we have one more thing we are calling as a temporary lectures TLs to help us. So they are given some more privilege in compared to TAs. So first of all, I want to discuss as usual evaluation pattern, and here again we have a few things. Like if I'm going to talk about this final in-sem exam, so here it's depend upon the coordinator of the course, because as I said, we have TLs, means temporary lectures, so we are giving some little bit privilege to them. So here the course coordinator, as me, I am the course coordinator for this semester, so I'm going to decide whether the in-semester examination paper is going to be of 40 or it's going to be 50, because it's a range is given to us between 40 to 50, not more than 50. And the second thing, if I'm talking about the mid-sem exam, so here range is given us to 20 to 25, not more than that. And then rest of thing is for evaluation pattern for the weekly quizzes, programming assignment, and obviously we are focusing here course projects also. So as usual in the weekly assignments, these are the surprise quizzes, and also as morning sessions are mentioned, instead of having a 55 minute or you can say 1.5 hour lecture, why not we have some sort of module based, means something like that 15 minute discussion about something, and then we have some few quiz, some sort of questions in between that, and then again we have a continuation of a second one module, something like that. So those things we are including here as usual, weekly surprise quizzes as usual, and in between classes whatever they are going to happen, this is thing inside this. And then the programming assignment, this programming assignment is especially for the labs. Okay, so we have a 3 hours lab. Okay, and this lab is compulsory almost for all, and for the conducting the labs of a first year student, we are conducting here in the Central Computer Center, and there around we have a round figure 100 systems, and those 100 systems are reserved for them, because our intake is around round figure you can say 800. So in a semester we are not able to give 800, so what we did, we divided this force into some sort of sections. So first 400 student is going to take this particular subject in a first semester, and rest of the students are going to take in the second semester, so that we are able to manage this. And then about the course project, so as usual we are also following the same kind of exercise. I don't think so, we are repeating questions more than once, whatever is our lab exam or is our in-sem or mid-sem. And in the lab they are going to execute, I think so, in a semester minimum 100 to 120 programs. That's what our lab exercise. We are not fixing them to execute 10 program or 20 program. It's not like that. We are preparing our lab assignment. We are giving to them at the beginning of the semester. Everything is available for them. Just go and download it and start working on it if you have knowledge. otherwise we are going to help them. And morning I saw one person raise your question, what about the guy, those who are not very well in mathematics. So in the NITK we have one more practice, and that we are having some sort of evening classes. This classes is entirely different from SCST classes, nothing. We have our one or two interested faculties, not for math department, even though from computer science, computer engineering department also, few persons from other departments also, they are ready to share their extra time with us. And helping them, we have a few students. Those are free of cost involved because they have an interest, they want to share their own knowledge with the guys, those who join us. And obviously, if he join us, means he is a little bit different from the other that we are assuming at NITK. So we are providing full-fledged information to them, what's your problem, where you are lagging, the type of information you are expecting from us. So this is also one of the place where we'll get the some sort of feedback. Means we have this sort of students also, and they are facing this problem. So we need to come up with some sort of solution for them also. So this is just something about our evaluation pattern. And then here just I'm going to talk about the computer programming. It's syllabus in the sense, just guideline is given to us. These things should be there in your course. Remaining thing we are going to frame, what the things I'm going to include it here or here or here, everything. So we assume there, instead of programming any starting any programming language or whatever is, it's very important to give some knowledge about the devices also that they are going to use for writing a program and all. So some sort of we have here computing concept, so some small concepts are there. Then we will discuss here some sort of component and systems, obviously some discussion about the operating systems, and then a little bit about the program executions basics. And then we have some sort of problem solving, or you can say some programming strategies we are discussing with them, and then little bit about the programming paradigms. And one more thing we are discussing here is something known as a software development life cycle. It's not in a you can say in a very big manner, just brief introduction, okay, so that they know exactly in which phase they are going to use this programming language for writing a program or writing some sort of codes for performing or executing a particular event, whatever is. And then as usual, C language, everywhere you are going to cover all those things, starting from basic, and then we have a control structure, array, and remaining things. And after that, sample questions and all those things. So, sir, sorry, I don't have a current soft copy, but I have all the hard copies with me, and before leaving department, I informed them. So very soon, they are collecting all the soft copy. So once I will go there, I will mail all the informations to you. And hard copy I have with me, if you want, those things I will submit it here. And if anyone is interested to see the kind of questions and all we are asking there, is everything with me, you can see it. And now the second thing, just we are talking about the computer programming lab. So as I told, as is a 3-hour lab for them. So here again some little bit about the operation fundamentals. And the second thing about the DOS, because again here we are using either SSH or we are going to use U12 or Telnet we are using, so like G++ compiler for CPP and GCC compiler we are using as usual for C, okay. And then we are starting this exercises. So whatever the lectures handled by in class with the help of quizzes or with the help of some sort of small assignment, after that they are coming in labs, and they, as usual we have a TL and TAs, and they are going to help them. So in the 3 hours lab, they will help in the sense, help in term of, you can say understanding a particular problem, help in term of syntax or logical errors, and help in term of why you are writing this program in a particular format. Is there any other way to write a same program by using same thing? So these kind of things we are discussing there in this 3-hour lab. So this is something about syllabus, and as usual everything is with me, hard copy if you are interested. And this is something about the lab infrastructure here. Whatever the lab infrastructure I'm going to talk about, these all those things is at the computer engineering department. I'm not talking about here central computer center. So as usual I'm starting from IBM Open Power Server Lab. We are thanks to IBM, they donated a 1 crore setup to us, this IBM Open Power. And then as usual we have all the labs. So one by one I will discuss just little bit about the all those things. So this is our IBM Open Power. As I told, this is a 1 crore setup, they donated us. So almost is up to date server we have, if you want to perform a, you can say a big computation on all those things, I don't think so we have any problem related to server and all. And the second thing is digital lab, I'm not going to talk about here. And the second thing about the PG students. So as usual, the moment the person is joining to us as MTech, we have MTech in computer science and engineering. MTech in computer science and engineering specialization is information security. So the moment they are joining us, we are assigning a one particular system to each and everybody. So the 2 years they are with us, those systems are reserved for them, and not a single undergraduate students are allowed to enter in the PG labs. In a special moment, if they are entering, they have a proper permission, then only they are entering. Otherwise, those reservoir labs are reserved only and only for the postgraduate students. Okay, so we have a, some sort of this configuration and all. This is for IS, information security students. This is for first year MTech. So we are calling as a PGCSE, PGIS lab. And now I'm going to talk about the undergraduate lab. So this is, we have a undergraduate Windows lab, almost up to date information with dual core or Pentium 4 machines. Again, UZ software lab. This is the lab donated by Intel. And this is MHRD lab, and especially this lab we are using for doing a projects. This lab is sponsored by MHRD to us. This is about the research lab we have for PhD students. And this is about the central computing center. So as I told, around figure 100 systems are there. So those 100 systems we are using for first year students for conducting a computer programming labs. So almost up to date systems we have there. And then we do have this thin client lab, but especially this particular thin client lab we are using for browsing purpose. So this is about the NITK and about the computer programming course. So if you have any question and query.
One thought process I have is that since most of the people who have spoken, they seem to have two consecutive papers, one on C and one on C++. Would it be better for us to run this workshop, which we are proposing, as an equivalent of just computer programming one, just concentrate on C programming, and then have another subject, which is object-oriented programming or something, which is equivalent of computer programming too. Would that be better?
Sir, my suggestion is if this particular workshop we are going to run for a computer programming,
yes,
it's better. Hmm. And then in the next program, if you are considering a object-oriented programming, so on that time we have a two options, object-oriented programming by C++ and also Java.
So is it because this is exactly what was observed by the previous coordinators also, that C programming appears to be the fundamental course taught at or to all the students. It's plain vanilla C. So you can compile C programs using C++, that's all. But are we not even permitted luxury of C in and C out? Okay, so let me put it this way then. So instead of approaching, what my original idea was, that we'll run the course as we are running in IIT, and then we'll spend 5 days in looking at both the papers. Now that may be difficult to do. So the suggestion is, we'll run the training for teachers using the IIT style, but we specifically will concentrate on C programming as they have to teach in the first semester in the last 5 days. So that should satisfy even those institutions which are using a combination. They can simply expand on the IIT style course. And this should also be useful directly for people who have paper one of this kind, where they can use some slides and some examples from this IIT style question teaching, but very specific material which is C-related. So for example, in my course, I would routinely use string class, because that is far more easier to handle. You know, when you can say string result is equal to string 1 plus string 2, is something which you cannot do in C. But on the other hand, if the teacher attending my course is going to teach C later, then this is completely useless. So he will have to still use arrays and do something. So maybe I could spend just not even 10 days, just 8 days in running this program in this fashion, and the remaining 7 days in just concentrating on C programming, as is obvious from the pattern. And we may have another repeat course of this, where we'll still do this combination once again for some other 1,000 teachers and do a proper C++ object-oriented course.
It's fine, sir.
So what we can do is, just to ensure technically we are correct, we are saying we'll run two workshops for this subject. We'll call it introductory computer programming as one subject, and the other we shall call object-oriented programming. Both will contain the introductory portion as same, but the remaining half portion, I think we can even do it 7 days, 7 days kind of.
It's possible.
Is that a better organization? Yes, I think 7 days will be better organized. Yes, correct. So 2 week program, 7 days the composite course as we conduct it in IIT. It's more like revision because all teachers are teaching computer programming anyway. But it's just to enforce that they actually do programming. And last 7 days strictly go by module and give them the modules and the sample questions and the assignments which are like C program. Kalpana, you should note this down. This is a major change in our organization. I'm glad we raised this because then tomorrow or day after when we meet our other counterparts, we can tell them that this seems to be the most favored. Okay.